Hey, what's up? Sam here. Like I said before, the first generation of LaserPecker was probably my most favorite gadget in months. I just love it. And now, for the Pro version. What's the Pro part? And how is the performance comparing to the original? We'll find all that out in this video. So first of all, for the unboxing, the biggest difference from the original is the Pro version has magnetic protective shields and of course the water focus supporting stand. With it, you can set up easily and get to work fast. I really like this supporting stand. It's made of aviation aluminum alloy, really well built and polished. You will feel it's solid and high-end. You can even put it on an end table as a piece of decor. To set up the machine, it's quite easy. Just unfold the stand, put the Engraver head onto the stand and connect it with the cable that comes with the box. And last, connect the stand to the power source. It can be a power strip or power bank. Now, long press the power key to turn on the stand. Then you can place the material you want to engrave under the head. Short press the power key, it will start water focusing. That's it. This is so much better than spray scissor. You don't have to use a ruler to measure distance and adjust the tripod manually. Just one key to save you all the hassles. As for the rest steps, they are the same as the original. Connect to your phone through Bluetooth, choose the picture you want to engrave, adjust the way you want, and engrave. Now about the results. The left is from the first generation, and the right is from the Pro version. Which one is better? As you probably watched my previous video about this, my first impression was really mixed. I do appreciate the Pro version generates more details as you can see from the picture, but at the same time, the engraving feel too shallow, seems not as powerful as the original. And this is something should never happen on an upgraded version. So I forwarded this issue to the LaserPecker official, you know, back and forth several times. And finally, the issue was perfectly solved. The trick part is you have to make sure choose higher depths when you are engraving. Like if you want to engrave on the filled material, choose 80% of the depth, just don't use the default 10% depth. You will get perfect results. Now you might ask, since the default settings are not working, then what's the point to choose the material when engraving? Can LaserPecker just update the app so we can use the default mode? Those are good questions, my friend. As I confirmed with the LaserPecker, they will update this very soon. How soon? Let's see. So, we've tested a lot, like really a lot of materials, like wood or cancer wood, some wood that I don't even know the name. But we just tested it. The engravings, as you can see, are just great. Really detailed. And now it can even handle the plywood, which is something really difficult for the first generation. It's amazing. We've also tested on bamboo, paper, plastic, ceramics, clothes, and even metal. But you know, I mean the painted metal, like those thermos bottles. I have to warn you, it cannot engrave directly on metal. To conclude, has the LaserPecker Pro improved from its predecessor? Definitely. With the water adjusting support stand and the new laser sensor, the Pro is easier to use and generates more detailed pictures and handles more materials. Basically, the LaserPecker Pro has all the functionality of the original, but it can also do so much more. So my buying suggestion for you is, if you have more budget, then just go to this Pro version. But if you have a tight budget or just want to give the laser engraver a whirl, you can take the original LaserPecker into consideration. They are all practical, fun, and easy to use. You can go creative as far as you want. And you know the thing is really portable. You can basically print anywhere, anytime. Alright, for the price and availability of the LaserPecker Pro and the first generation, you can check out the link in the description or on the screen. And if you haven't subscribed yet, I suggest you click right here to subscribe. I'm Sammy, see you next time.